Now that we've seen a bit about how NetLogo works, let's build our own simple model. This model will consist of one ant moving around randomly, and that's it. So let's start up NetLogo. I'm going to click on this NetLogo 5.0.3 icon. You can click on whichever version that you have. Now the first thing I'm going to do is create the setup and go buttons. So I go to this part of the menu that says button here. This is actually the interface builder menu, because when I click on it, you can see all the different types of objects I can add to the interface. So we're going to add a button, and I just click on the interface, and I can fill in that this button's going to be for setup. Okay. And then I can get another button. I have to go here, click, add another button for go. Okay, so now I can select this by right-clicking on it, click select, and I can move it. I can actually change its size if I want when it's selected by dragging it here, moving it back and forth, and so on. I can adjust the buttons however I like. So now we have the setup and go button. They're red because they don't have any code associated with them yet. That is, there's nothing that they actually do yet when they're clicked. So I'm going to have to fill in the code. Now let's create the code that go with the setup and go buttons. We do that by going over to the code tab and writing the procedures. So the first one we'll do is setup. So we say to setup, here's what we do when the button's clicked. We clear all. Clear all is a command that clears the world, that is the place where you see the ants or anything else carrying out their actions. It clears that window and it clears up anything else left over from any previous run. We're going to reset ticks. That is, we're going to set the ticks or the time step to zero. Now we're going to create an ant. Well, you should know that every agent in NetLogo is actually called a turtle. This is for historical reasons, coming from the original language Logo that NetLogo was based on, where all the agents were turtles. Actually, in Logo, you just had one turtle. Here, we're actually eventually going to have many turtles, but for now, we're going to say create turtles, and we're going to say how many to create. Well, we just want one. So we're going to create one turtle, and then we're going to ask it to do some things. We say ask turtle, and I'm going to give it a list of things to ask it, and the list starts with this bracket. We're going to ask it to set its shape to bug. That's the shape of an ant that's built into NetLogo. We're going to set its size to 3. That's a good size for viewing it. I'm going to set its color to red. Okay, and I think that's all we want to ask it to do, and we put end at the end. Now there's this nice check mark here which checks the code for bugs. So I'll click on that, and it tells me there is a bug. It tells me about where the bug was, right in here, and I notice that I actually should have said ask turtles. I missed an S there, and the reason is that NetLogo always assumes there's a population of turtles or agents, and whenever you ask to do something, you ask the whole population. At least for this loop, we're going to ask all of them. Well, there's only one of them, but we're going to change that later. We're going to ask all of them to do this. Okay, let's check this again, and it brings me back to the interface telling me that everything seems to work. So let's click setup, and here we see our ant right in the middle. The go button's still red, which means we haven't yet written the code for that. Now let's write the go procedure. We go back to the code tab and we write to go. We're going to ask the turtles to do a few things. First, we're going to ask them to turn their bodies to the right 30 degrees. So we say right 30, And then we're going to ask them to move forward 4 steps. Forward 4. Okay. Then we'll increase the time steps by 1. That's what the tick command does. So remember, we reset the ticks, that sets it to 0, and then we tick, which increases it by 1 each time we go through this procedure. And then end. Okay, let's check this. Everything looks good. Let's go to the interface and hit go. And you can see that the turtle moved its body, it turned its body by 30 degrees and then moved forward 4 steps. And we can keep hitting the go button over and over again, and it goes around in a circle. Well, I'd like to be able to have it go forever without me having to continually hit the go button. And I can do that by right-clicking on go, going to edit, and you see this option forever, which I can click, which means that it'll just keep repeating go forever. So let's do that. And if I slow it down a little bit, you can see that the ant going all by itself, around and around and around and around. And I click the go button to stop it. Now if I want to start it up again, I can click go again, and that will start it up, stop it by clicking go. Or if I want to start over from scratch, I click on setup again. And notice if I keep clicking on setup, it starts in the same place, the center, but it points in a different direction each time. That's because what setup does is it puts the ant right in the center and facing in a random direction. Now we can save the model so far by going to the File tab and clicking on Save As. And I'm going to save it as Ant1. And you'll see it here. It appears on the desktop, ant1.nlogo. So now I can actually go to NetLogo menu, quit NetLogo, and if I just want to start this up, I just double click on this and NetLogo will start up and load this model. There's only one thing wrong with our model, and that is that it is boring. All the ant does is go around in a circle. So let's make it a little more interesting. And I can do that by going to the code and adding one simple command, which is, instead of turning right 30 degrees, we'll add the word random. So now the ant will choose a random number between 0 and 30 minus 1. That's what random 30 does. And we'll turn right that many degrees. Each time it goes through, it will choose a different number. And we could do the same thing here. We can have the ant move forward a random number of steps between 0 and 4 minus 1, or 0 and 3. Let's see what happens then. So we go back to the interface. Let's do setup and go. And you can see that it still roughly going around in a circle, but it makes the behavior a little more interesting. Now, one thing you might notice is that the ant seems to go through the wall here on this side and come out the other side. And in fact, the world, this black area, actually wraps around at the edges. So the whole world is shaped, you can think of it as being shaped like a donut or a torus, where this wall actually, even though we see it as being flat, it's wrapped around to touch this wall. So if the ant, see if we can make it do it. So if the ant goes through, went by a little too fast, if the ant goes through the top, it can come out the bottom. We're not seeing the bottom here. Or if it goes through the side, it comes out the other side. Well, this kind of makes it look a little strange, so what I can do is I can right-click on the world, this black area, edit, and turn off. This actually gives a lot of information about the coordinate system that's set up in this world, And the number of so-called patches, which are the sort of the grid the world is divided up into. But what's interesting for us is these default check marks, world wraps horizontally and vertically, we can uncheck them, apply OK, and let's see what happens then. Now, the ant, when it hits the wall, it'll actually get stuck there and not be able to move until it manages to turn around. So that makes the ant look a little bit more realistic. Okay. Even though our ant can move around randomly a little bit, it's still not very interesting because it only ever turns to the right. So let's write some code that allows it to choose at random whether it will turn to the right or to the left. Essentially, it's going to flip a coin. Each time it moves, it's going to flip a coin, decide whether it's going to turn right or left. So let me implement the coin flip procedure. I'm going to use something called toReport. Okay, coin flip. A report procedure is different from a to procedure because this one actually returns a value. This one's going to return true or false, corresponding to heads or tails. And all we have to say here is report random to equals zero. End. Okay, so what this does is random to, if you remember, random returns an integer between zero and this number minus one. So this will return zero half the time, one half the time, but in a random way. If it's zero, this says random two equals zero. This is a statement that will be true if this is zero, if random two is zero, false otherwise. And this reports whether this was true or false. And so what this whole thing will, the value of this whole to report coin flip procedure will be true half the time and false half the time, except in a random way. So we can use that up here by saying if else coin flip. What that does is it says if coin flip is true, do this first thing that I'm going to put in brackets. Otherwise, if it's false, do the second thing that I'm going to put in brackets, left random 30. So if coin flip is true, we do right random 30. If coin flip is false, we do left random 30. So every time we run the go procedure, every time step, it'll decide at random whether to turn right or turn left. So let's see how that works. I'm going to set up and go. And you can see it's turning in a different direction. It gets stuck, but it's turning forward, right and left. And our only problem is it's getting stuck too often. So we can fix that, make it a little better by changing these 30s to 60s, letting the ant turn, have a bigger turning radius. That is, it turns more each time. Try it again. And let's see if, yeah, it seems to be getting stuck a little less often and looking a little more realistic. There it goes. Whenever you write a program, it's always a good idea to put in some comments. So let me go back to the code here. A comment is just a little bit of text that you put in your program that's ignored by the computer, but it's for the benefit of people to read. And in NetLogo, a comment is just some text that's followed by text following a semicolon. So I can write here a semicolon. Now I can write anything I want and the computer will ignore it. So let's write returns true or false at random, which is what it does. And here we can put another comment here and say if coin flip is true, turn right else turn left. Okay, so there we have little reminders either for ourselves or for somebody else who's going to read the program about what these different little pieces are doing. Now, this is really helpful if you have a more complicated program, especially if you come back to it after, say, a few days, and it really helps you to remember what you've been doing. So comments are absolutely essential, even if nobody else besides you is going to read your program. Now we're ready to save our model. First, I'm going to label it, and that's just an aesthetic thing, but I'm going to go to the interface menu and choose a note, and I'm going to put up here a little bit of text that says the name of the model, Ant1. And let's make the text a little bit bigger. Let's make it 18. Okay. And then I can select this and select this and move them down a little bit, center them, do whatever I want to make it prettier. And now we're done. So we just save and we can quit NetLogo and the model is saved. I just wanted to mention that the purpose of teaching NetLogo is just to give you a sense of how it all works. We're going to be using a lot of NetLogo simulations in this class. We're not going to be writing very many, but I wanted you to get a sense of how the code works, how the interface works, and so on. And you yourself will be probably doing some modification of some of the models that we look at. And if you're even more advanced or motivated, you can try and write some of your own. As an assignment, instead of a quiz for this subunit, I'd like you to implement that exact same model that I just did, Ant1, using the same statements I used, and get it to work. That's going to be ungraded, but it's for your benefit to see that you understood everything that I just showed you. And don't hesitate to ask questions on the student forum if any come up. That's what it's there for.